Hey guys, welcome back to another HitFilm tutorial. Today we're going to take a look at 5 tips to hopefully get you down the right track to creating your own 80s motion graphic. You can find the template that we're using for the example down in the description. Tip number 5, if you're looking for reference images on Google and you search for 80s title or 80s retro design, you'll notice that it's basically a requirement that your title has a grid. I don't make the rules, I just make the VFX. Luckily, HitFilm has a built-in grid effect. Drop it onto a new plane if you want to be able to add more effects to it without affecting the rest of the composite. You can use either the position numbers in the controls panel or the on-screen viewer controls to adjust the grid. The border radius changes how thick the lines are, and the feather softens the edges. Tip number 4 is to use different colored drop shadows. An easy way to add extra color to your design is to use the drop shadow effect. The shadows don't have to be black and probably shouldn't in this case. Make your words pop by choosing a color that contrasts or complements your text. There are several parameters you can adjust to get it looking the way you want, including the angle, distance from the original text, and penumbra, which is how blurry it is. Tip number 3 has to do with the fonts that you use for your titles. If you're unsure what kind of font to use, try one that is blocky or robotic for the main title, and one that looks more like a handwritten brush script for the subtitle. This combination was prominent in a lot of the reference images I found. You can find the fonts I used in this design linked in the description. See the card on screen for an in-depth look at working with text in HitFilm. Tip number 2 has to do with color, specifically how you fill the elements in your scene. Basically, the rule is use color gradients for everything. The main title of the images I reference pretty much always had a color gradient instead of a solid color fill. HitFilm has a few different types of gradients: color and radial gradient, which can each have 2 colors. One is for a straight line and the other is in the shape of a circle. There's also the 4-point color gradient effect for mixing 4 colors together. The colors you should choose for these gradients leads me on to my next tip. And tip number 1, if you haven't noticed already from the colors in this stand-up or the example motion graphic, strong neon colors are a must if you're designing retro. Bonus points if it's pink or purple. A great effect for this is the neon path effect, found in HitFilm Pro by default, and the VFX neon lights pack for Express. This effect allows you to draw a path using masks, or draw it directly onto a text layer. I used it to create the purple triangle in this design. The extension property allows you to animate the progress of the line. That's it for today. Be sure to let us know if you have any questions down below. If you're interested in creating the actual Stranger Things text, you can find that tutorial on screen now. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you all in the next video.